I've got a question here. This is from the coaching group. If you want the best coaching out there, join DreamRider.com. We go through every single question. If you want to be a YouTube star, you want to be a fake natty or TRT or vegan or cycling performances, weight loss, better parent, better boyfriend, girlfriend, just real time coaching. I don't just specialize in cycling or vegan or weight loss. I specialize in all of it, you know. Passionate about all these topics, relationship, everything, communication, the whole gamut, the whole kit and caboodle, the whole bicycle, not just the frame of the wheels or the tires, the whole lot. This is a question from Rob. Rob is 6'1". I'm just reading off the screen here. 6'1", 105 kilos, recovering drug addict, 120 days clean from ice, endone, and booze. Long-time DR fan. Lost weight when I was younger on the protocol. I was put on endone 2 years ago after a car accident, started using other drugs because I lost all emotions from the painkillers. Opioids, man, that's a full-on, you know, probably one of the worst drugs out there, I reckon. I was 20 years of age. I did steroids from Christmas Day till mid-January, 250 milligram test a week. Had to stop because of health reasons, getting clean. I feel my hormones have been put out of whack and I'm probably having some post-starvation weight retention. First of all, I think anyone who's 20, yeah, you're 6'1", you're 105 kilos. You know, in my opinion, you don't. My strong opinion, strong experience, you don't have a testosterone deficiency if you're 105 kilos, 6'1". You know, you might test low on paper, but that's probably got to be your opioid usage that suppressed your HPG axis. All right, so if you throw in some TRT on top of that, yeah, sure, you'll feel better. You feel amazingly better, but you're treating the cause or you're just treating the symptom. You know what I mean? You're 105 kilos, bro. Get off the opioids, get off the alcohol, all of a sudden the testes will start working as they always have in your life. You know what I mean? So it's like, I can put the hat on, you know, I can put on a hat. I thought someone's coming through the front door. I can put on a hat and, you know, what's the analogy here I'm trying to get? Like, let's say I'm trying to itch my scalp here, but I can't because I've got the hat on. It's just not the same. Oh, this, you know, I can't itch my scalp. Take your freaking hat off, get your finger up there and itch it or something like that. You know, like, it's just treat the cause, not the symptom, man. People are drinking diet soft drink. This is full sugar soft drink. And they're thinking it's the sugar that makes them fat. So they go to KFC, they have their bucket of chicken or their fatty burger. They think it's the fat-free sugar drink that's making them fat. Dude, it's not. It's the fat you eat, it's the fat you wear. Treat the cause, not the symptom. Introduce the sugar back into your lifestyle. Introduce the rice and fruit. All of a sudden, you don't want as much fatty crap. And all of a sudden, you go, wow, I'm losing all this fat. I'm becoming fat adapted because I can finally burn the fat on my body versus keep fueling my face full of fat and just restoring all the fat I'm burning each day. Get fat adapted, man. Cut out the dietary fat. Let your body burn the fat you already have. Where's the logic in eating more fat? If you've got enough fat, it's like cleaning a white shirt with mud. I've got mud in my shirt. Hey, give me more mud, I can clean my shirt. Oh, I've got too much fat in my body. Hey, give me more fat. Stupid. But hey, we all do it, don't we? Critically think, people. So I do not recommend this guy use steroids. You know, do not recommend it. Because you're 105 kilos, man. And you haven't even, I'm being like harsh here. I'm being like, you know, Uncle Durnrider, Coach Durnrider here. I'm being real with you. You know, I'm talking to you how I want someone to talk to me if I was in your shoes. So I'm going to say, dude, one, you don't have any blood tests to prove your case, your state, you know, your state, your case. You know what I mean? You don't have any blood tests before, during, or after. I'm just like, why on earth would someone take anabolic steroids or hormones and not test to where they're at to start with, not test during to make sure it's not getting fake stuff or doing too much or too little, and three afterwards? It's like, you know what I mean? I'm like, it baffles me, man. Right? You need to do blood work every 2 weeks, every month to see what things are going on, to understand how, you know, the pharmacokinetics of these things you put in your body, how they work in you. All right. You know, so anyway, but hey, it's great we're being transparent. I'm not punishing this honesty here. You know, the more honest people are, the better I can help you. Right? I'm not about punishing anyone here. This is, I'm just, you know, the more real people are with me, the better I can give the direction. You know, people say, I want to go north, Harley. I'm sitting south here. I'm sitting southwest behind the pine tree. Okay, great. Walk around the pine tree, go up the steps, boom. when people are like, oh, I'm sitting over here in the corner, I'm like, dude, you're behind the pine tree. I can see you. How can I give you the right directions if you're going to lie about your location? That's the saying. So Rob fears his hormones be out of whack. So you did Christmas Day to mid-Jan. That's 2 weeks. That ain't going to shut down your HPJ axis. If it does, it won't be for very long. But the opioids, that stuff can shut you down, you know, and be very, very bad. So I'm not against painkillers. I'm against people being addicted to painkillers. You know, I'm against people using more painkillers than they really, really need, all right? You know, I've had some injuries where I've used painkillers, I've used tramadol, etc. I'm like, man, this stuff's, or even the endone, even I tried. So this stuff's strong. This stuff, you know, no thanks to me. I'll stick with ibuprofen. I'll do a half tab or I'll do a quarter tab. And just only when I really, really need it. You can use THC, medicinal. You can use CBD. You can use warmth. You can use water therapy, things like that, sunshine. You know, cut out the oils in your diet and the animal products, the proteins, the inflammation, the inflammatory amino acids and inflammatory fatty acids, your carbohydrates, pH neutral. So you have a diet of mostly carbohydrate, grains, fruits, sugar, etc. It's mostly pH neutral. Sugar's pH neutral. Sugar's acidic. Sugar's pH neutral. Fat, protein, always acidic because it's fatty acids and amino acids. So things like that, you know, you can look at your diet and the ways to reduce pain. I'll be going the CBD, THC droppers. I'll be going that route. Not smoking it, but just using the drops. I'll try that versus go the synthetic or the opioid route. That's what I'll be doing myself personally if I have severe pain. But again, you know, like often people just, they use painkillers to numb themselves out, man. And that's on you, people. That's on you. That's on us. Like that comes where, that's where we're, You're how old are you? You're 20, so you're an adult now. You're a man. And to be a man, we've got to act like a man. And that's just about, you know, putting things in context. And if you want to use anything for any pharmaceuticals, you need to use them responsibly versus just being like, oh, well, I'm entitled to this. The doctor said I can use this much. It's like, okay, and then that's how you get your addiction going on. That's how you shut things down by taking what you recommended to take, which is often too much because they want to sell more scripts and blah, 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 blah. So start off small and work up, titrate up, work it up from there. Versus just bang, bang, bang. I remember I had an asthma. My asthma was so bad from the cats and I was eating all these oily vegan burgers and I was hard to breathe. I couldn't really pinpoint what's going on. I'm like, what? I've had a cat allergy all my life, but it's getting really bad now. I'm trying to train and stuff. So I went to a doctor. He's like, you know, just try a prednisone. You know, because I was reading about, I'm going to try a pred. So I'd get a doctor script for that. And the dosage they gave me was insane. I didn't take it, man. I was just like, I didn't resist. I just took the script, got the tablet, put the tablet in quarters, I think it was, a quarters or halves, like a 5 milligram tablet of prednisone. And within 10 minutes, I was like, I could breathe. And I was like, man, this is stuff strong. And I'm like, how much do they recommend I take? Like 60 milligram a day or some BS. And it's like, really? I'm getting an effect on 5 milligram. And they want me to take 60 milligram. I'm glad I didn't listen to them. I'm glad I used some common sense, critical thinking and started a little small. Start real small and then see how much I really need to get the effect. And then bang. And then I had no come down. I could use it whenever I wanted. I use it maybe a handful of times. And then I've made a connection. The more oil I eat, the worse my asthma is if I'm in the presence of cats. There's no cats in this place. So if I eat some oily food, my asthma's all right. But as soon as I go back to the allergy world, you know, so I treated the cause versus address the symptom. Just taking pred. It's like, oh, I'm an asthmatic. Nothing to do about it. So yeah, there's a time and place for pharmaceuticals, but we also want to be smart when we use them, man. Otherwise we will get, our body will punish us. All right. So this is great, Rob. You asked me some really good questions here. I appreciate it. You know, I appreciate you and appreciate yourself for wanting a better life. So yeah, just to say it again, I'm not trying to be harsh. I'm just trying to keep it real. Just trying to help you help yourself. I started working recently. I've been in sub 20 grams of fat per day. Usual day is 2,500, 3,000 calories. That's not enough for a 100 kilo boy. Oh man, my weight's gone down 3 kilos, only 3 kilos, which means that you probably, you know, who knows what's going on, maybe metabolism, but, you know, not counting the weight I lost coming off the roids, my work is sedentary, I cycle only 2 kilometers per day to and from work, most days I'm walking 3 to 5K, well, that's better than nothing, that's good. I'm hoping to get some advice on how to reduce stress and get my hormones back in check. I understand the crime, I understand I've done the crime, that's good. And I'm willing to do the time. Very good. I haven't done blood tests, but I have pretty standard low T symptoms. You got to do tests. Low libido, anxiety, etc. My sleep has been a routine for me now. In bed before 10, wake up at 6 a.m. I know today I don't have a drug problem. I have a me problem, and I make sure I'm doing what I need to do to have an attitude of gratitude in my life, but I fall short because of the stress. Any advice would be appreciated. Thanks, Harley. So you're 20. You're 20. Like, if we've got stress at age 20, we're bringing it upon ourselves. All right. Pretty much any age, but especially when we're 20. You know, you have a massive amount of freedom. You got more freedom right now in your life than you ever have. You don't have kids. You've got a job that sounds like you just pack up and leave tomorrow. No worries. You don't have any staff you're looking after. You don't have any responsibilities full on. Your job sounds like you could be gone in the 5 minutes and they'll replace you in the next 5 minutes. It'll be like, hey, cool, wow, if I train someone else to do this, blah, blah, blah. It's no big deal. So your responsibility out of 10 right now is 0 out of 10. You don't have any kids, doesn't seem to have a girlfriend or a partner, etc. And your job is something you're not really that passionate about. And so it's a ceiling. Like, you just, it's like a, you got a bottle of lemonade. It's like you lose it, big deal, get another one. You know what I mean? Like, you live in the lowest stress point in your life. So if you have stress right now, Rob, then you, the universe won't give you better things, because you can't, if you can't manage this, how are you going to get it? You know, how would you manage your dream life? And that's where the stress really can kick in. You know, like, you got your dream girl. I'm assuming this person's hetero, either or. You say this is a dream partner. It's 2021. You got your dream partner. You know, you got your dream job. Then you got your dream bike or your dream fitness or whatever, dream lifestyle. And then that can get taken away from you like that. And that can be stressful. Like, if you lose your job, let's say you're working, what are you doing? You got a sedentary job. You know, let's say you're working in a factory like I used to work, and you're just putting part A to part B, you know? And you lose that job, you're like, oh shit, all right, get another chick kicker job, whatever. Big deal. But let's say you're a YouTuber and you absolutely love it, and then you shut your channel down, shut down, banned from the internet. That's gonna be stressful, you know what I mean? That's happened to me. And that was stressful. But now it happens, it's like, whatever, so I'm starting your account, blah, 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 blah. You know, so, you know, and I've built my name so much over the last 12 years, I have an audience and people always, oh, I was doing what I'm up to, blah, blah, blah. It's not, I'm not starting from scratch, you know. And I've made enough money to be set for life financially, so it's all good. But, you know, even if I lost everything in my life, you know, lost Natasha, lost all my money, lost everything, I still have the skill set to recreate all that, almost. You know, Natasha's irreplaceable. She's one in a billion. But, you know, I'm just saying that the more you're living your dream life with your dream partner, like, and then it gets taken away from you, then that can be, give you stress. Or you're thinking, oh, I don't lose this. I really, really value this. I really, really value this. That brings stress, right? So your stress level now, 0 out of 10. It should be 0 out of 10. Or let's be generous, let's give you a 1 out of 10. Right? Does that make sense? Because if you can't handle right now your life, it's not your dream life, and your stress is like up here, broski. Yeah, that having that stress isn't because of low T, bro. That's not because of low T. That's because of you just, you know, not realizing, not personifying how lucky you are right now. You're 6'1", you know. And I just jumped at the door. Back, it was the neighbor's door. So if you can't handle life right now, getting on steroids, man, is gonna, damn, that's gonna make you so much more stressed. When you start taking exogenous hormones, stimulants, caffeine, Dexys, Ritalin, Modafinil, all these things, start experimenting with recreational drugs, as you already found out, bro, the stress goes up. Stress doesn't get better. Oh, I've got low testosterone, I've got anxiety. I'm going to use testosterone to feel... No. No, that's not how it works. Because then when you're on testosterone, you're going to have side effects. You're going to have libido issues, excess libido or no libido or less libido. You're going to have issues with hardness, too hard, not hard enough. You're going to have issues with your blood, your hematocrit could go up or blah, blah, blah. You're going to have issues with your prostate, your hair might thin. And if you're 20, that could be a real big issue. You know what I mean? So... it's like, you know, not that it should be, but for some guys it can be. So if you can't handle you now, natty, You will never, ever be able to handle your enhanced self. No way. If someone can't handle their sober self, they cannot handle their drunk self. And just because you can handle your sober self doesn't mean you can handle your sober self. But if you can't handle sober anxiety, no way. No way. And I'm speaking from personal experience here. I've taken prescription, not fake EGL stuff that maybe it was legit, maybe it was half dose. Legit. I've taken prescription, Anadrol prescription, Anavar prescription, testosterone of all different esters, anthonate, cyprinate, propionate, decanoate, undecanoate. I've taken these prescription, you know, sourced legally from the local family doctor. All right, so I understand exactly what it feels like to be on these various exogenous hormones. And do I recommend it? No, not at all. But if you are going to do it, go see your family doctor, you know. Because it just changes you. I didn't understand what I was getting myself into when I first started using anabolic hormones from the doctor back in 2014. I had no idea. I mean, I'm a very, very responsible adult. I like to think I am. Some people disagree with that, you know. I'm about harm minimization, risk reduction, blah, blah, blah. You know, being aware of what you're doing, you know, how you make people feel around you. But man, I had no idea, you know, what I was getting myself into. No idea. I thought I did, but I didn't. So if you're 20, you're too young, in my strong opinion, to be playing around with these hormones. Just, and you're 105 kilos, bro. You don't have a testosterone deficiency. You can't have a genuine testosterone deficiency at 105 kilos. You can't. Oh, but my levels are low. Your levels are low because one, you're stressing yourself out. It's not the stress. It's not low T causing the stress. I mean, that can happen from the endone and stuff. There's a little bit of a cascade there, but you got nothing to really be stressed about at that age, all right? You don't. And it can be the caffeine and the coming down. That can give you the, you know, stuff like that. But you're on the right track, Rob. You know, you found me. You found the path. That sounds like BS, but it's true. You found the reality that you do control your thoughts and emotions. That's your choice. And you know, you found cardio. You found doing weights. You found your sunshine. You found early nights. You found water. You found low-fat diets. You found these good things. You understand adaptive thermogenesis, and it's okay if your body goes up and down. Blah blah blah. It's okay. You know, so you found ways to minimize your stress because you're not attaching the meaning. Excess means things don't mean that much. So throw in anabolic compounds in the mix, man, you're going to have way more anxiety. Like, you don't know what anxiety and paranoia is until you start taking steroids, man. Wow. Some of the shit that goes through your brain when you're on steroids, mostly when you're coming down a bit, or even going up, you know what I mean? In the blood, it's not, you never like flatline. Even if you microdose every few hours, there's still little variances there, you know? Who's doing that? Who's microdosing every few hours? I want to do it. No, you're not. No one's going to do that. Like, no one's going to dose a 2 milligram every hour. Like, you know, you might for a month or a week or whatever, but eventually, off this. And then eventually, rally kicks in. So I just don't recommend it. I recommend getting off all your painkillers, your opioid ones. And if you do have pain, work with, you know, do better at reducing your fat and protein intake. Get full sunshine and just go to freaking Mexico, man. I'm not sure where Bob's living. Hopefully he's not in Mexico already, but go somewhere that's warm and chill and you can just recover, man. You're 20, bro. Go to Thailand, go to Philippines, go to Vietnam, you know, volunteer with some organization, just help with a backpack hostel, just get a, you know, get a girlfriend over there or whatever, just get a vasectomy and just live the good life, bro. You're 20. Live the good life, man. Live your best life. The best life isn't jabbing yourself, bit of fake nanny, getting swole. Yeah. Entrepreneur, no, that's all bullshit. I know because I've lived all those lives and had friends, you know, in various circles. The best life, really. If I was 20, I would just go straight to Asia or straight to Mexico and live that rural lifestyle. 100%. Why waste your time with the broken Western system? Men and women broken in the Western system, you're trying to, like, why? You know, it's like getting a bicycle with all these proprietary parts that's 20 years old, the chance of finding those proprietary parts for properly priced is like zero. Like you're just burdening yourself with this BS responsibility when you could go get $1,000, get a nice what's a good bike, you know, it's just a Trek, a Monda, you know, something like that. It's just a 27.2 seat pros and it's 1.5 fork, just a real easy bike to manage and deal with and travel with. And I mean, like, what you, man, why? Oh, because, you know, that's what my guys in my school are doing. And fuck, you know, that's what I would be doing. I'd be going straight to Asia, man. Straight to Africa, Kenya, Uganda, Rwanda, just living the chill lifestyle, man. And you know, sometimes I think to do that myself. I'm like, I'm here to spread this message. That's not for me. I would be in that country. I was like, man, I need to help people. I need to get this message out there. I need to be doing YouTube and stuff. And I love my life here in Adelaide and traveling with Natasha and the cats and stuff like that. I really love it. I've created it. But that's my advice for our friend here, Rob. He's 20, man. I'd be like, man, just, you know, get out of the Western system, bro. The Western system, for most people, chews you up and spits you out. It's really, really, and it's just getting worse and more chaotic, man. So yeah, doing steroids, man, it'll just, don't do it, man. It won't make your life better. You don't need them, man. You're 105 kilos. Now, let's say you were, you know, you had testicular injury, you lost a ball sack, you're doing Lance Armstrong style, and you want to improve the quality of life because you just physically, you do all the right things, you can't produce enough tests, then for sure, jump on with the supervision of your doctor and do your homework, etc. And use pharma grade prescription quality stuff. Don't use the fake underground, dirty arsenic, lead contaminated, who knows what's in it? You know, injectables, etc. Who really knows what's in that underground shit? You think there's people who are making underground drugs care about your health, or they care about this? I mean, sure, Big Pharma as well, but Big Pharma's got a little bit of a liability going on there, you know? So if you're gonna give yourself tests, I would be going Pharma. But in your situation, I wouldn't be using it because you don't need it. You don't need it. You're not underweight. You don't have sarcopenia. You don't have mad anemia. You don't have any real, in my opinion, real medical need for taking exogenous hormones other than, I think this might help me, but what's going to help you is you changing your life and changing your thought processes and getting the fuck out of Dodge. That's what's really going to help you. You can treat the symptom with taking some exogenous test and just open up a whole can of vegan worms. That's what's going to happen, man. Whole fucking, look, it's already happened now. You did like a few injections for a few weeks. Now you already think, oh, I've got, blah, blah, blah. Can you imagine if you stay for a few years, bro? Like, don't do it, man. Don't do it. This is coming from personal experience. I'm age 43. You know, if I was 20, there's no way I'd recommend it, man. No way. Which 20-year-old would I recommend, you know, using anabolics? Someone who had a burns victim in hospital, you know, they're wasting away. They had a bone fracture they wanted to recover from, something like that, some fast acting, you know, anabolics to help them. It was still just short term as well. Assuming they're mentally okay to be able to do that, handle the come downs. There's a come down when you come off. And well, I'm going to smash down this for my life. I was like, oh my God, that's just so dumb. So dumb, man. 20, 105 kilos? Using anabolics is like, you know, as a thing to treat anxiety. It's like, you don't. Low libido can be so many things. Going to bed too late. You know, if you go to bed if you're 20, in my strong opinion, strong experience, when you're 20, you need to go to bed at least 8 p.m. At least if you want the peak hormone experience, go to bed at 8 p.m. And that you know, that's like, and white sushi rice. That's like, for dinner with whatever low-fat sauces you like, you know, that's killer in terms of libido and mood and unlimited sugar, cereals, cornflakes, etc., low-fat things. I would say what it feels like to be on 250 milligram a week test, pharma grade, Bayer, from the doctor, not 250 milligram underground arsenic, you know, carbonic acid, rancid safflower seed oil or whatever from the bin at the fish and chip shop in Uruguay. Legit Bayer, made in Deutschland product. It feels the same being on that 250 milligram Bayer quality pharma grade prescription level. What does that feel like? That feels like going to bed at 8 p.m. every night, getting all your carbs in, etc. Your white sushi rice, in terms of libido and motivation to get things done. I'd say it's about that. I would actually say that going to bed at 8 p.m. and the carbs is more powerful than 250 milligram of test. What does 250 milligram of pharma grade test give you? you're gonna put weight on. You're gonna stack on the weight. Look at me, how different I look compared to, you know, pre-2014 when I was 60 kilos or whatever, and I was faster runner back in 2013 than I am today. You know, I put on like about 11, you know, up to 16 kilos depending on which body weight you're using. About 76 kilos today, and I've been as low as 59 kilos. So, you know, 10 to 16 kilos extra weight's gonna put on you. That's what's gonna happen. You're gonna put on more weight. So people, I want to lean out. It's like, well, don't take steroids. Steroids don't lean you out. Steroids are anabolic, they build you up. Yeah. The low-fat diet leans you out. You know, the training the muscles helps you get more toned look. But if you got fat and you take steroids, all that happens is you just gain even more estrogen, you gain even more weight. This is dumb. So my recommendation is people lean out before they jump on. Otherwise, you just, you know, your body's aromatizing all this testosterone and estrogen more because you got more aromatization factors in there. You know, aromatase enzymes. It's just, yeah, just treat the cause. Don't use steroids, kids. Don't use steroids. Like, unless you have some sort of extreme reason for it. And that's not because I've taken pain pills, I'm going to bed late, and I think my teeth is low. No. Well, I took Psalms, and, you know, it's like, man, like, you know, this is a long-term commitment here going on here, and, you know, if you got anxiety now, it's going to get worse. That I guess that's the premise. If you have anxiety and low drive now at age 20 or 25, taking gear isn't going to help that. Right? Isn't going to help that, because going to bed early and upping the carbs to unlimited amounts is going to help it more. Much more. The only thing I notice when I go off gear is that I start losing a lot of weight again. And I go back to the camera ran out of the test. So the only difference I notice is when I go back to Natty Land. So I'm 76 kilos right now. If I went full Natty Bra, you know, same diet, same training, my weight, I would lose at least 13 kilos today. If I went Natty, no more, nothing. No more anabolics. I would lose 13 kilos in maybe 2 months, 3 months. I don't know exactly how long, but I would go back down to at least 63, 64 kilos, maybe even lighter still, probably even lighter still, because I'd be totally shut down. So the more shut down you are, the lighter you'll become, which isn't good for your health. I'm just saying, you know, so then eventually my body will come back up and I'll probably come back up to like 63. So maybe I might even go down to 55, 57 kilos. Who knows? Like, whoosh, my estrogen and my test would be so low, you know, just suck it right up. So 57 kilos probably, and my cycling performance would be pretty good. You know, my mood would probably be fine for my lifestyle. Libido would be like on and off, but yeah, I'd be you know, I'd lose maybe 13 to 16 kilos I am now, or more, maybe even 20 kilos less than I am now, and I'm already super, super slim. So that's the difference. But in terms of mood, I mean, you know, when I use anabolics, I don't want to ride my bike as much. You know, I want to, yeah, it's more a sexual vibe. It's more, you know, I want to do weights. You know, I enjoy doing weights, but I don't really have the same romanticism for cycling and running like when I'm full natural. So I would say that, you know, when I'm got no hormones in my system, no exogenous hormones, I want to ride my bike more. I'm more motivated to go and ride. I'm like, wow, I'll do a 200k, I'll do a 400k ride today. I can do that. You know, I want to ride across Australia again. Yeah, that's what it does. So that's the difference. So the only advantage for me is I look more manly, I have more muscle, I look more aesthetic in that aspect for those things. And you know, and I feel very, very, very strong when I'm lifting weights or boxing or kickboxing. You feel superhuman like that compared to your normal self. But in terms of cycling, you know, I feel better when I've got nothing in my system. And you feel like, in terms of like cycling, climbing and 5k marathons, you just feel like, you know, you feel less, your muscles don't feel as bloated, as stiff. You feel very super, super skinny. You feel like a twig in the wind. You feel amazing. feel amazing on the bike, you know, but when you've got a bit more muscle than you used to, people look at me and see you've got like a body that's small, you think you're not muscular, you're a twig. And I am, but relative to, you know, full twig blown during a ride, full natty during a ride, there you feel like you just put your hand in your jersey, you can wrap your hand around your neck, and just your flexibility is insane. The less muscle you have, the more flexible you are. So you just, yeah, just that limberness, you feel that when you're full natty bra. That's just my personal experience, you know, from taking pharma prescription grade product. People have their opinions like, well, you've done what I've done. You know, no, you haven't. And if you have, then you know what I'm talking about. So that's my opinion there. So yeah, steroids make you gain weight. They make you gain weight. So, you know, you'll gain weight on steroids. There's no doubt about it. Like, you can't take steroids and not gain weight. I mean, unless you took like an amount that didn't even register in the blood. Yeah, so it's like having a, yeah, is it alcohol in this glass? I can't see it, but I had a drop of alcohol. A lot of shot in my blood? No. Did I drink alcohol? Yes. I mean, it was lemonade, but you know, just hypothetically saying, versus a bottle of alcohol. You know, so it's like, you can't take a, you know, a proper amount of anabolic steroids and not gain weight. It's just not how it works. People think steroids make you shredded. No, no, no. They help retain muscle when you're starving yourself with doing stupid shit like that. They don't. Like, look at me, like, I'm still the same body fat. I should probably be more body fat than I was 10 years ago before I started anything. I've just got more muscle. There's no difference. You know, I'm still lean, but I've got more muscle there. It's just adds muscle to your body. And I'm actually hungrier as well, typically. Especially Anabar, this prescription grade Anabar. Man, I'm fucking eating so much more than I used to be able to eat. It's amazing. So yeah, that's the deal there. You know, only take steroids if you're prepared to gain weight. Only take steroids if you're prepared for extra anxiety, extra stress, extra problems, extra side effects, etc. You will have side effects. You will have issues with your skin. You will have issues with your balls, your dong, your hair, your liver, your kidneys. You'll have issues with potentially excess blood, blood clot risk. You're going to have issues if you take anabolic steroids. There will be side effects depending on how much you take and how long you take from what you take. Is it UGL arsenic, you know, fish and chip oil from Uruguay content? Is it pharma grade, you know, Bayer, whatever products, you know? So the side effects are dose dependent, etc. How long you take stuff for. Just putting out the information. There's great channels out there. One guy put out some really good information on anabolics is a bodybuilder in Thailand, Dan. Me and Dan disagree on diet, but we, you know, he's definitely got a lot of experience about anabolics out there. And he also very transparent about his experience with anabolics. So that's, I guess, the tip of the hat and a double thumbs up from me. Dan, the bodybuilder in Thailand, he's got a great podcast, the steroids podcast, so information about that. But again, it's like, you know, you listen to these things, you're like, oh, yeah, I'm gonna do that. Yeah, 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 I'm gonna just drink strong and be more of a man. And yeah, and it's great, but again, understand the side effects. And if you're 105 kilos, it's gonna be more of a man. It's like, well, what? You're already a specimen. You're already a specimen, you know what I mean? So, depends what your goals are in life, you know? So, it's, yeah. I'm glad. This is, for me, this is an experiment. The whole thing's, I like having these personal experiences and relatively low risk. But yeah, I get to share them and get to speak from experience. So that's my strong experience based opinion right there. Don't do it. Don't do it. If you can't handle your life now, you will not handle it. It's like if you can't handle your bike at 10k an hour, going at 100k an hour is going to be a bad thing. If you can't handle your bike at 60k an hour, going up to 100k an hour, it's going to be a bad thing. Well, I'll just get better balance. I'll be on faster. I'll be better balance. No. That's not how it works. You know, you'll hit a rock, you'll come up to the corner, you get magpie swooping, you won't know how to deal with it because you couldn't deal with it at 10 or 60k an hour. So that's what steroids do, is they just exacerbate your anxiety. They exacerbate it. You just read the forums. You jump on a TRT Facebook group and, oh, I've been on TRT for a year and, oh, I haven't had a boner. I want to use heaps of Cialis and I need to do this and blah, blah, blah. So hang on, like, this person a year ago thinking, oh, I've got the Holy Grail here. No, it's not. It's not. So you just go on these TRT forums and look at all the problems people are having. You know, like, they're genuine, not trolls. They're genuine people out there. I've got more anxiety. I've got more anger issues. I've got blah, 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 blah. I've got bloating. I've got this weight gain. I've got sore nipples. I've got gyno. I've got blah, 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 blah. All right? So it's not this big romantic thing out there that people say. I mean, it can be life-changing for some, but there will be side effects. If you've got anxiety now, that ain't nothing compared to the anxiety you have down the track in Hormone World. Right? Just saying, people, just saying. Give me a heads up.